So 3, 2, 1 with the pilot. So we're up in the air now, if you're able to see. I'll try to fly it a little bit closer, but this is a Gebb RC Crocodile Plus, very, very fast. I'm gonna see if I can get the punch out on where the angulation is. So you can definitely see this battery's got a lot of power in it. Anyways, we're gonna take it out facing towards the patch. This is the tree line that I was talking about. So when I was around here on this tree line, I would get about 3 bars out of 4, maybe 2 bars out of 4 on my drone signal. The remote signal goes much further, and I usually never have a problem with the remote signal, but the drone signal is 2 to 3 bars out of 4. Right now we're at 3, and actually right now I'm at full bars at 51 megabits per second, or 50.8, so that's pretty max. Now look, we're going way past that tree line that I talked about, and we're still in line of sight straight down the path, and I'm still at full 51 megabits per second. I'm in a completely other neighborhood, and I'm 3 out of 4 bars right now. So turning back around, getting signal of 2, showing me red, and look how far out we are. But so far, so worth it. I got them for about $45, these patch antennas. Like I said, I still have stock on the top, so I'm imagining if I got stubbies on the top, it would be even better. Does it do acro? A lot of people ask that. Sorry, I just hiccup. Does it do acro? I'm in acro right now, but does it freestyle? Yeah, pretty much. I mean, look how crazy I can fly it, and it's just super stable. You know, I can do all these things with it, and it just levels off. We can even try following this little school bus over here, which is some of my favorite things to do. I feel like a little puppy. Anyways, so a lot of control with this quad. I love it. It's super light, super nimble. I crashed it once, fixed the arm. I have only good things to say about it. I fixed my arming issue now, so that was like the big pet peeve I had. These patches work awesome, and I definitely recommend everybody upgrade from stock. I don't have enough data to compare it with True RC. The True RC Airs, which are supposed to be really good, or even the AX2 HDs that recently came out. Choosing between this and those, and these were just in stock, so I got them. They're not real carbon fiber, they just have a carbon fiber print on them, but super awesome. Anyways, I'm just doing these videos because it's kind of fun to share this with all the family and friends that kind of are a part of learning about all these things. And as much as I love flying, I also love the technical side of all this too, so it's kind of fun to share it. By the way, this battery is amazing. So right now I'm on 15.2 volts. If I zoom up, 14.6. There's not a whole lot of sag on that, so which is awesome. So I really, really like this battery also. It's a 4S battery, 850 milliamps. So we are just cruising up here. I'm gonna come do a little swoop down, and you can kind of see what that looks like. So the other thing is, what happens if I go out of line of sight on these patches? How good are they? Once again, this is a 1,000 milliwatts. If I can go all the way back here behind the house, I'm still at full signal. So this is very, very awesome. This was not happening before, so super impressed with this. Also, what is the width of them? Pretty, pretty wide. I mean, look how far out east I am. The flight time on this 850 milliamp battery at the Crocodile Baby is around 6 to 10 minutes, depending on how I'm flying. If I'm zipping around real, real high, doing a lot of these flipperoos, then it's obviously going to be less. It's fun just to cut the throttle off and do a little dive like this. And look at that, you can catch it. Is it going to be like a 5-inch? I don't know, but it does catch amazing. Once again, I'm just trying to share this. I don't have any type of crazy statistics or any type of insane things. I just want to see if, you know, the stuff that I'm buying is worth it and to share with other people. And I would definitely recommend these. One, the drone, Gebb RC, and two, the iFlight patch antennas. Definitely, definitely recommend them. super awesome. It makes a big difference to your confidence level when you're flying far. It's like the trees change color so quickly this year. By the way, everyone, that Stone Mountain in the background, super beautiful. I love being able to see that. I think if you point this way, you can see downtown. I'm not sure. I think that's Kennesaw Mountain. Let me see if I can find downtown. I guess not. Oh, it's right there. Towards the east, you can see downtown far in the distance. I don't know where I am right now. Okay, I need to coordinate myself. Sometimes you get so lost when you get this high up. Here, we can do a little dive. Throttle completely off. I love doing these. I want to be able to go through those houses, but I'm still learning. Soon, you should get one of those for your viewing pleasure. All right, we got him on. Installation was as easy as it can get. The only thing is that these old black screws that come with the actual headset, you can't use those. You have to use the new screws. There's a little bit of excess wire over here, so it's kind of tricky, but I would just try hand tightening these and not use a wrench or anything, just not to mess up the connector. But it's looking pretty awesome, and maybe one day I'll end up replacing these. But in the meantime, let's go check it out.